Hi. These days we are releasing videos, one on second Saturday and one on the fourth Saturday of the month. But since even last week, last Saturday, we didn't release a video, I thought I'll release one small video today. And this is a two-part video. The second part will be released later. This is part one of two videos that I'm going to share for road building. The second video will be shared later. Just the other day, outside the office, some people came to fix the road. Our office is a bit set off from the main road, and the access has been a mud and stone road. Even though I've seen road building process many times over all over the country, I realized that like everything else, I'm sure there'll be some things that one doesn't know about and we take it for granted. So let's see how these basic tar roads are made. The trucks bring the stone, which they dump wherever they feel like. Then the people move these stones into the trays, which are carried on the heads. These are the most common trays in India at any kind of construction site. Earlier, the same things were made with steel, and it must have lasted a lot longer, but then it was really heavy. Plastic must be a happy alternative for the poor laborers. They throw the stones onto the road area, and as you can see, there is a method in the madness, and some lines are drawn to mark the edges. The throwing also seems to be a specialized skill, because only a few chosen ones do that, and it does spread out nicely when it falls. Then comes the road roller. Its job is to press all the stones so that they are at one level. These road rollers can be about 10 to 12 tons, and that's about 10 times the weight of a small car. It literally flattens almost anything that comes in its way and leaves the stone tightly packed on the road. Before they go to the next step, there is a complete carpet of these stones that is flattened by the road roller. After that, they pour hot molten tar on the stones. This is literally sprinkled on the stones so that it covers it all in a nice thick layer. The tar is like a glue for the stones, and it will set and become rock hard. I generally always feel bad for people working with tar, because India is a country where the summer temperature almost touches 50 degrees Celsius. And then imagine people working with tar on these hot roads in the open sun. Luckily today the temperature is lower, just about 32 degrees. Let's take a look at how the tar is being prepared. Wherever hot tar roads are being built, you'll see a structure like this. And this has wheels so that it can be moved around. And this is the stove in which the tar is melted. Tar is a petroleum byproduct that comes in these drums, and in the beginning it is really thick, almost like a solid. One of the specialists works on the drums to open it. It's a very rudimentary but effective way of tearing open the top of the drum. And then he has to make a hole on the side to hook it to the winch. This is a geared mechanism to lift the heavy drum to the top so that they can pour the tar out. The person working the drum needs to be really strong, because he also has to balance this drum while it is being lifted only from one side. And then he tilts it to tip it over. Here the tar is melting and it becomes more liquid so that it can be poured out easily. It is poured out of these taps and carried in the buckets that we saw. You can see him pumping the kerosene oil that is burning inside with the air pressure. Without this air pressure, there would be no air for the fire to keep burning. Tar is a carcinogen, which means it can cause cancer, and the fumes therefore are very dangerous. But sadly, people are not given masks or gloves, and even when they are, they don't wear them because it's too hot and sweaty. And everyone anyway thinks that it's not going to happen to them. Now after this carpet of stone that was laid and then the tar was poured, now again they throw some more stones over it. These new stones are much smaller, and their job is to fill up all the gaps between the other stones and make the road surface smoother. Since these smaller stones are crushed from the bigger ones in big machines, there is a lot of dust that flies out. It is inhuman to work in such conditions, but then they need to put food on the plates. The next time you see them, consider thanking them for the job they do. Here you can see the size difference between the first layer of stones and the second layer. On the right side of the screen, the second layer has also been flattened over the first layer, and it sticks properly because of the tar. This man seems to be a perfectionist. He went around with this tub and sprinkled the smaller stones where he thought there were a few less. The road roller guy seems to have the most cushy job, far from the dust, though he can't escape from the heat because the whole vehicle is made of metal, so it's quite hot. The road is left at this stage, and they are supposed to come back a few weeks later to finish the rest. I will make another video later to show the final steps. See you then for part 2 of road building.